हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू द क्लास और ओरल्स मरीन हब यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द बंकरिंग ऑपरेशंस एंड बंकर प्रोसीजर्स, एंड वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द बंकर चेकलिस्ट आल्सो इन दिस वीडियो। ऑल दिस इज डन बिकॉज वी नो द बंकरिंग ऑपरेशंस आर वेरी क्रिटिकल ऑपरेशंस ऑन एनी वेसल, सो वी शुड बी मोर केयरफुल बिकॉज इट इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द मारपोल रेगुलेशन एंड ऑयल स्पिलेज। So this file which I have opened before you, this PDF you can find by clicking a link in the description of this video. So you have to just click that link and it will lead to your download of the PDF of this file. So this file is published by the ISGOT and by OCIMF. So let's read out. The spillages and the leakages during the bunkering operations are a prime source of oil pollution from the ships. Experience has shown that many of the bunker overflows and spillages that do occur can be attributed to human error. This chapter hereby provides guidance on the planning and execution of the bunkering operations that includes an example of a pre-transfer safety checklist. So you must have understood the basic fundamental of this discussion of this bunkering operations. So first heading says general, all the bunkering operations should be carried out, planned and executed in accordance with the MARPOL regulations. Pollution caused when heavy fuel oil is spilled and particularly damaging and difficult to clean up. So the personnel involved in the bunkering operation on board, they should have no other task, like they should remain in their workstations during topping off. And this is particularly important when bunkers are being loaded concurrent with the cargo operations, because many times the cargo operations are being carried out and the same times the barge comes in and the bunkering is being taken, like operations are being done. So in order to avoid the conflicts of the interest of the operational personnel, the spillages often occur when staff are distracted by another task. So the prime reason of every personnel involved in the bunkering operation or like any other task, the spillages usually occur when they are being distracted by the other task. So we should be focused that okay, the bunkering operation is being carried out and the cargo operations are also being carried out. So one, the personnel have to be very much alert. So let's discuss the bunkering procedures. The companies should require that all the bunkering operations are controlled under the procedures that are incorporated in the ship's safety management system, that is ship's SMS. These procedures should ensure that the risk associated with the operation have been assessed and that controls are in place to mitigate these risks. Hence, the procedures should also address the contingency arrangement in the event of a spill. So the procedure should be already laid down. Also, the company should consider the following items when producing the procedures. So the below are the basic procedures and the steps before any company should consider before carrying out the bunkering operations. The first being determining that there is adequate space for the volume of the bunkers to be loaded. Secondly, establishing the maximum loading volume of all the tanks. Third, the controls for the setting of bunker system valves. The controls should be known and they should be well, they should be properly controlled. Determining the loading rates for the start of the loading, bulk loading and topping off. Like there should be proper mention of the loading rates, at what rate the bunker should be taken during the starting, during and after topping off. Like there should be three loading rates. Special precautions when loading into double bottom tanks. Just in case you are loading into the double bottom, then special precautions should be mentioned. Arrangement of the bunker tank ventilation, most important, because If that bunker tank ventilation is not there, then it is actually leading to the like it may lead to a dangerous condition. So ventilation should be proper and this should be clear. Internal tank overflow arrangement, most important, because just in case there is overflow happens in any of the bunker tank, then there should be proper lined up overflow arrangement that it should go to the overflow tank, like in most of the vessels you can find it. Verification of the gauging system should be operational and accurate, because if your gauging system is not accurate, then how will you will get to know that the quantity is being filled up in the bunker tank is correct or not. Alarm settings on the overfill alarm units. So the alarm settings should also be calibrated properly, that okay, up to this percentage of the bunker tank there should be alarm ringing. Communication with the terminal to establish when bunkering can be undertaken. Next, communications with the bunker supplier prior to commencement. So to establish and to record the loading procedure to be followed and to determine how much quantity and quality checks should be carried out, particularly if safe access is needed between the ship and the barge. Methods of managing the handling of bunkers which have or may have a H2S content. Testing procedures of determining the presence of hydrocarbon gas or H2S vapors. Like there should be testing procedure, like gas meters should be properly kept along with the bunkering procedure. Method of determining the temperature of the bunker during the loading. So temperature gauges should be there, or there should be some kind of temperature like most of the tanks have temperature gauges. Communications procedure for the operation during emergency stop. If there is some spillage or there is some emergency happens, then should be communication procedure should be also provided. Many requirements to execute the operation safely. Monitoring of the bunkering operation and checking it conforms to the agreed procedure. Okay. Changing over tanks during the loading. And lastly, containment arrangement and cleanup to be available. That means cleanup equipments include your 5-7 barrel kit and the SOPEP kit. Like they should be also available and kept ready and standby. So once the procedure is produced, it should be implemented by use of a checklist and example which we'll be discussing shortly. So till now we have understood the major points of carrying out the bunker procedures. Okay. Now the bunkering operation, prior to commencing the operation, all the pre-loading checks should be carried out and communication systems should be verified as working. There should be pre-loading checks. Also, during the bunkering operation, the loading rate should be checked regularly by regular sounding of the bunker tanks. We should know that okay, in this time the flow rate, in this flow rate for X meter cube per hour. So you should keep on taking sounding of the tanks every half an hour or every 1 hour as per the checklist. So it should match with the loading rate. When changing over from one tank to another, the care should be taken to ensure that excessive back pressure is not put on the hose or the loading lines. Because suppose one tank is being filled up, now you have to fill to the another tank. So should be taken care of about in this case, because there should not be excessive back pressure on the hose or the loading lines. And during the bunkering is being finished off, like after topping off, the loading rate should be decreased to reduce the possibility of air locks in the tank. This is very much important point which usually people do not consider. It should be decreased to reduce the possibility of air locks in the tank, causing mist carry through the vents and to minimize the risk of supplier not stopping quickly enough. So these points should be also taken care during the topping off. On the completion of loading, all the hoses and lines should be drained to the tank if applicable, back to the barge prior to disconnection. So all the hoses and the line should be drained off to the tank. The practice of blowing lines with air into the bunker tank is a common one. Like we all know that most of the people are blowing air in the lines into the bunker tank. But there's a one problem. It has a high risk of causing spillage unless the tank is only the part full and has sufficient ullage on completion of loading. So up to here we have discussed the bunkering initial, what are the points we should be taken care of and how the bunkering procedures are being done and what are the bunker operations, like what all steps should be done. So this is the first part of the bunkering operations. In the next video, we will be discussing from this point, this bunkering safety checklist. So in the next video, that is a part two of this video, you will discuss the bunkering checklist step by step, that what all points we need to fill and what all points we have to keep checking during the bunkering procedures. So I hope till now we have understood the basic and the important points of carrying out the safe bunkering procedures. So if you have not subscribed yet to this channel, please do subscribe because it is very much useful for our fellow seafarers, especially for the people appearing for the MMD class 4 orals. Thank you so much.